Hey there, and welcome back. So today we're going to continue on in our series on creating a WordPress block theme. Last time we took a look at the designs for Semplice Monospazio, which is the block theme that I created for WordPress just to see how to create block themes. Today we're going to continue on by looking at the theme.json file, as well as some styling that I had to do because not everything is covered through the theme.json file. If you don't know what the theme.json file is, basically it's the file where you can control a lot of the styling that you otherwise would have to do in CSS. It's a very, very powerful tool in a theme developer's toolkit, but it does take a little bit to learn how to use it. So today we're going to walk through the theme.json file for the theme so that you can learn how to use it for your theme. Before we get started, if you want to see the rest of the videos in this series, as well as other videos on web development and other things, be sure to hit the subscribe button and the ring the bell for notifications. Now, let's get started. Okay, so here we are in the theme.json file for the theme. Now, before we begin, I do want to note that the GitHub repository for this theme is linked to in the description below. I also have the link to the WordPress.org page where you can download the theme. And also, I have created a starter FSE theme in GitHub that you can download and use that code to help get you started. And in fact, a lot of the code that you see here is stuff that is in that file as well. So anyway, let's go through the theme.json file. First off, you want to be using version 2. This is the latest version as of this recording, and it has all the great features that we want to see. Now we're going through the settings. Obviously we want the appearance tools to load. And for this theme, I'm totally okay with having custom colors, custom duotone, and custom gradients. But we are removing the default gradients and the default color palette. And then beneath that, we are defining our own color palette. It's a good idea to have something that's primary, secondary, tertiary, or background, foreground, or something like that, because it will actually make changing out the colors for different block or theme styles much easier, as you'll see later on in this series. But for now, just kind of keeping the black and off-black, off-white, and a white down here. Dark and light versions of each of the colors that we talked about last time in design go here. And you do also just want to make note of the slug, because that's really what you're going to be using throughout the rest of the theme and with everything else you do. You don't really need to worry about the hexadecimal color code. So then we get down to gradients. I don't really use gradients much in this theme. I probably could stand in later versions of this theme to update the gradients to be correct, but for this early version, I'm not too worried about that. But we can define the gradients, and here we would define sort of what color goes where, and the things that you would put in the CSS. Now we're putting in this theme.json file, which is a little bit easier to read. And same sort of with the duotone, we could add that here. I don't really use much in the duotone in this theme right now, but again, in future versions, I might want to update that. Next, we're going to define the spacing units we're going to use for this theme. I'm just going to keep it simple with pixel, EM, REM, height of the viewer, and the width of the viewer, and then sort of standardizing the layout with the content size, which is sort of like the normal, and then the wide size, which is the align wide. You'll see these come into play more once we get into the creating block patterns. Next, we're defining our typography. We're allowing there to be custom font size for the user can select that specifically. We're not doing drop cap just because, I mean, it doesn't really work with what we're trying to do with the theme. But you certainly can if that's the design you come up with. And then here we have the font families. I'm only using one font family, Ubuntu Mono, as I mentioned last time. But something that's now in the theme.json file with WordPress 6.0 is the ability to add in these fonts locally. What I'm doing is loading it into this folder, web fonts, and then calling it here. Simple as that. Very easy. Font weight, if this this file was like a variable font weight file, I could define, because we're only using 400, 700 font weight, I would do this. If we had an extra bold, we'd do 900, something like that. But in this case, this is just the regular font, and then we have a specific bold one down here. And you would just load these in individually like this. Next, we have our font sizes. I'm doing 16 pixels for small, quote unquote, and then regulars are 18 pixels, all the way up to where what will be an H1, as you'll see later, is 50 pixels. And we have our custom, just variable other things to do with typography, spacing, the font weight, we're all using regular and bold. and then line height. And now we get into the really fun part where we're starting to style different elements and as well as different core blocks. So here we're defining some of the spacing. We're having about a 10 pixel gap between blocks. Here we're setting sort of the text color is going to be the primary, which is the black or off black color. And the background is the off-white color or the secondary color. And then we're defining sort of the base typography, the font family, font size, font weight, all that. And you'll notice once we have it defined here in the theme.json file, we're using a CSS variable product. And this is where things get a little bit tricky and you need to pay attention because it's obvious, as you can tell here, it's not the same for every attribute. So like color has the WP preset color, font family is fairly similar, WP preset and font family, but then for some reason, font weight and line height are WP custom. Something that you just kind of have to check in, and you might have to go into the inspector because all these get output into the inspector. You scroll all the way down to the bottom of the CSS styling, you should see them. And then here, we're defining some of the styling for elements. So like for the link, it's the same color, it is underlined. For all these headings, we're setting the font size. And then next we get into the core blocks and we can set some predefined styling for these blocks. Biggest example here is the button. We have the background color, which is going to be the off black. And then the text is the off white or secondary color. And then we have the typography, basically the font size, font weight. You could put the font family if it's different from the body font family. I definitely did this with my personal website theme because I was using two different fonts, one for headings, one for body copy, and I was using the heading font for the button fonts. And then we can define what the border looks like, if it has a radius, how wide it is, all that fun business. And we have spacing. And you have this is a lot of these are available for almost all of the core blocks. And you can define all of them or you can define none of them. It's really up to you. The button's going to be a big one. A lot of these are pretty simple. There's not a whole lot you really have to do. The cover block here, group block. Obviously, a lot of these are really small changes just to make sure things look how we want them to. And you can make them as complex or simple. The pull quote here. Now, I will go ahead and say, as we noticed with the button block up here, there's no thing here for like different states, like the hover state or the focus state. Unfortunately, we still have to use CSS styling to make that happen. I mean, it gets a little bit tricky with the button block, especially if you have a ton of colors like we do for this theme. Hopefully that gets fixed in future iterations on Gutenberg and WordPress, but for now we still need to use CSS. We're also going to see that coming up with the pull quote and block quote blocks. Have sort of our navigation, just putting in the styling. Really, I would go through the theme.json file for this theme, which you can find again in the link in the description below. And also a theme I used a lot for setting up this theme.json file is the Frost WP theme by Brian Gardner. It was very helpful, it was very thorough, and it continues to be updated. And it's a really good guide for the theme.json file. You also might want to check out the 2022 theme.json file for reference as well. But really, I would take some time to play around with it, you know, change a few things, hit save, reload the theme, reload the site editor, see what's changed, all that fun business, because it's really, really cool. You can also define template parts, give them names, slugs, all that, and then even custom page and post templates. And we can define whether it's going to be a page, or it's only going to be available for a page or just a post or another custom post type. So that's really the theme, that JSON file in a nutshell. Again, just play around with it, see what you can do with it. And quickly, I'm just going to go through the buttons, CSS. All of this CSS is post CSS and it's getting compiled when I run a gulp function. And a lot of this I got from the WP rig theme. So the starter FSC starter theme that I have linked to you in the description below. Has a lot of functions where you can sort of run styles, compile style sheets, minimize the JavaScript, and then even bundle the theme. That's all available for you to use through node actions and gulp actions and whatever. But we're gonna end today with the buttons.css file. Just looking through it, you will kind of need to target these, at least for the moment, when you're doing all of this. You probably don't need a whole lot of this anymore.
just because this is a lot of carryover from other legacy PHP themes that I have built, but I still just have it here and I might remove it in later versions of the theme. What we're really focused on are these hover states that'll help us to, you know, do something when someone hovers over it or focuses it through their keyboard or whatever technology they're using to browse the website. As you'll see when we start to really build out this theme in the site editor, when you give a button a background color, it adds in this has background CSS attribute or CSS class. So we want to target that, and then it will also give you a new CSS class that has and then the slug for the color and then background color. So I'm targeting each of these really just to make sure that the colors are correct. You can tell these are this is obviously the color slug that we defined early on in the theme.json file. So it makes it pretty easy just to sort of repeat over and over for each of the colors. I haven't really found a good workaround that eliminates this part yet. Hopefully that is coming. We'll just have to wait and see. And then there's also another variation of the block, or the button block, button whatever, is with the is style outline. And this is basically almost like the inverse of what we have with the hover state on the normal one, where it's the outline and then sort of like a white background or whatever. Here I'm just also defining that just to cover my basis for now. Hopefully, again, this gets fixed later on. But I would highly encourage you to go look around. Again, this is all in a GitHub repository. You know, see what it is. You can download it yourself or fork it and make changes or do whatever. But really familiarize yourself with this theme.json file, because there's a lot in here. Even though I had to do a lot with the button styling, it's still all of this pales in comparison to what the normal CSS that I would have to write for a legacy PHP theme. This really cuts down a lot of the CSS that I have to do when I'm creating a new theme.
So that's it for today. I know we covered a lot of ground today with the theme.json files, but do you have any questions about it or how to style block themes? Be sure to leave them all down in the comment section below, and I'll do my best to answer them. Next time, we're really gonna dive into the fun parts of creating block patterns for our theme. To see that video and other videos in the series, as well as other videos on button development, be sure to hit the subscribe button and the ring the bell for notifications. But that is it for today. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time.